how to apply wisdom in your business. I've been joined this morning by Educationist. He's also the pastor of pastors and a Bible teacher. He is the founding overseer of the Alive International Churches, Bishop Dr. Gordon Kisseh, my guest. Good morning, sir. Thank you very much for your time. I used to listen to you as a boy on Radio Gold at the time with my big brother. Mm-hmm. And you always started your conversation by saying that wisdom is the principal thing. Yes. Therefore, in all you're getting, get wisdom.
That's right.
What is wisdom?
Thank you very much, Mr. Hughes. I'm also honored to be here with all the viewers to share with you what wisdom is all about. Mm-hmm. Now, wisdom is not a particular thing you can lay your hands on. Mm-hmm. Wisdom is so vast, mm-hmm. it's so big, it's so huge, that we can only scratch the surface of wisdom.
Okay.
Because Jesus Christ himself is wisdom. Mm. And so the beginning of wisdom is the fear of the Lord.
Okay.
So as we fear the Lord, we begin to explore into wisdom. Now, wisdom is, number one, what you know, what you do, and how you do it. Mm. So it's not so much of just the intellectual knowledge that we have,
okay.
but the ability and the power to know what to do, and the ability and the power to know what not we should do.
Okay.
So both knowing what to do and knowing what not to do gives us wisdom. And it's also the discretionary application of the knowledge that we have. Mm. So we can't finish knowing this until we are called back home.
Okay.
That's why we daily strive to get to know the Lord more. And then as we know the Lord more, we get to know what he wants us to do. In summation, the entire scriptures can be seen as wisdom.
So then it means wisdom is progressive.
Yes.
Wisdom is goal-based.
Yes.
How do we apply it in our business life? And I'm asking this question because there are people who are spiritually apt. They can speak fluent, lucid tongues. They can explain the Bible very well. But they are not smart at business. How does that happen?
Thank you very much. You know, we have not been able to do the connection between what we know in our churches as Christians and when it comes to the business field. Many of us, we leave the things we do in church at church. And then when we come to business, we try to find other ways to do business. The Bible says in the book of Acts chapter 1 verse 8 that you shall receive power when the Holy Spirit is come unto you. Now that power there is a power for your totality. It's not just power to speak in tongues and then when you go to business, then you are a dwarf in the business. Your power that you use to speak in tongues, your power which is a creative power, the power God breathed into you is the power to do things. So the reason why we are not able to make the transition is because we have not actually thought of it. Now if we start thinking of it, we can do it. So then the power we have in church, the power we have as believers, we should bring that power to bear. And that power will come only when we have the renewal of our minds. In Romans chapter 12, verse 2, it says that we must be transformed by the renewing of the mind. So if that happens, then you'll be able to know that, oh, good, then what I do in church, I can apply it in my business. But if I don't do it that way, it means I am beginning to behave like somebody who is not a Christian. I have the mindset all right, but I don't use it in my business. And so this is what we want to be talking about, to be able to connect what we know in church and bring it back into our businesses. When we do that, then get Christ in us will help us to succeed in that business.
We'll talk about renewal of mind some more later, but a follow-up to this, what you have just said.
Yeah.
So the Bible says, don't be yoked with unbelievers.
Right.
And I am a Christian businessman. There's another guy who is running a parallel business that I need to collaborate with, but he is not a believer. He doesn't apply the principles of the Bible. He lives in the world and he does things in the world. Can I have a collaboration, a business collaboration with such a person and still not go against the Bible, for example, my Christian beliefs?
Yes, you can. Because the scripture there doesn't say we should shun the unbelievers. But when Jesus came, he befriended many unbelievers. He was a friend of tax collectors and sinners. So if you are a Christian businessman, you can have relationship with unbelievers. You can do business with them. But then your way of doing business, the approach of your business should be Christian based.
Business is not for the Pope.
No.
Somebody said that before.
You see, when an unbeliever is coming to business, he has one aim, profit. He wants to make sure that at the end of the day, the books are balanced, he has profit. So the way of getting that profit is his priority.
Okay.
He tries to be very hardworking, give his whole strength into his work. He tries to be as close as possible. He doesn't share his secrets.
Right.
He also tries to make sure that nobody comes around to compete with him and take the business over. Unfortunately, when Christians come into business, we use the same way.
Okay.
We don't trust people. We come with mistrust. We don't even trust God. And so because we don't trust God, we try to run the business ourselves. Now, can you imagine someone who wants to do it, who wants to have a table? You want to look for a carpenter to do a table for you, or you want a tailor to make a shirt for you. You want to go for the best. Now, look at how God has created this world and how he's run the world so well for all these years. Okay. So if you are a Christian and you want a business partner, God must be your first business partner. And if you don't take God as your business partner, he will leave you to struggle on your own. So there are many Christians, they are not using Christian methods in running businesses. And because of that, we are struggling, we are making a lot of mistakes. And you see, the only way you know you don't have wisdom is when you start making mistakes.
Okay.
Because wisdom is to help you do what is right. And wisdom is also to prevent you from doing what is not right. So when you start running into problems, you know that I'm lacking something. So you go back to God and God will give it to you. So businesses must be turned over to God. You can't be smart with God when you are doing business. You have to turn over to God when you are doing business.
You're talking about wisdom for business success. That's right. The title of the book. So what then is business success? Is it when you have all the money? Is it when you have 10, 15, 20 enterprises? You have a conglomerate of business. You have a lot of people that you employ who are on your pay list. What is it? What is business success from a Christian point of view?
Thank you very much. You know, success in general is not static. You can never arrive at a destination and say, I'm successful.
Okay.
Now, success is the progressive realization of predetermined, well-thought goals, balanced by belief and stabilized by faith. So there are four components of success. Number one, success must be progressive. So whoever you are, wherever you are, you have some level of success. The further you are alive, the father, you are healthy.
Okay.
These are things which you should thank God for. So you start from there. Then progressively, you set goals. Now, as you attain the goals, they help you to aim at other goals. So success is a progressive realization of well-thought goals. The goals should not just be arbitrary. You must consider your goals very well, set those goals, aim at them, and as you set those goals, they will help you get to higher goals. Now, progressive realization of well-thought goals. They must be balanced by belief. Every businessman must believe in himself. Believe that God is using you to attain something. Believe that God is using you to become successful.
Okay.
Now, if God is in you, Christ in you is a hope of glory. Now, you should be stabilized by faith. Faith is calling for things that be not as though they were. So nobody starts business to say it's going to fail. We all start, we're going to be successful, but many people fail.
Why is that?
Because we haven't been able to seriously consider the challenges in business. There are challenges, it's like goals. There are goalkeepers to every goal. You see, the goalposts are not empty.
Right.
So when you set your goals, don't forget that there are other challenges we are going to face. So as a businessman, count the cost, trust in the Lord, begin to know that Christ is going to give you the power. But you must also see to it that your goals are realistic.
Okay, so I have prayed. I have fasted about the business. I have consulted my pastor.
Yes.
And he says, well, it is clear.
Yes.
Go on and do the business.
Mm-hmm.
But then he gives me direction or a contrary.
Yes.
And says, well, I should shut my shop every Wednesday and come for prayers for about 3-4 hours.
Yes.
That's my belief. That's my faith.
Yes.
Maybe. But how does that impede on the business I do when my competitors who are in the world are there Monday to Friday, nonstop, making all the money, changing lives, shifting paradigms. Mm. And I'm locked up in church, you know, twice or once a week, trying to pray into the business. How does that improve business success, for example?
Good. There's a book which is written by Jim Collins. Mm. Jim Collins talks about from good to great. Mm. He says that the enemy of being great is good. So many people, they are just remaining at the good end where they are. Mm. But they must move from good to great. Mm. Now, your business can only go as far as you allow yourself and the God whom you serve to help you bring the business to grow.
Okay.
Now, praying alone cannot make the business work. You must pray, but you must also work. And working alone cannot make the business work. So you must set a balance between the times you go to work and the times you go to pray. Mm. I dare say that if you don't pray, your business will not succeed. There are people, the Rockefeller family, there are people, David Green, who, for instance, this tablet we have, the phones we have, they are investing so much money to be sure that we read the Bible for free, all the versions, and they put it on millions and millions of phones. These people are Christians. They go to church, but they also give to God and God's work. Now, why are they succeeding? Because they've made God the business partner.
Okay.
So if we in Ghana or wherever we are, we want our businesses to succeed. The wisdom is that turn the business over to God. He will run it very well for you.
I see. Why are we launching the book? Is it launched already?
No.
Where can we get the copies to buy?
Okay, we are launching it at the Marriott Hotel on Friday.
Tomorrow is Friday, right?
The 19th of July at the Marriott Hotel, 11 a.m. in the morning.
Right. Can we have the book so I can show it out there?
Sure.
So 11:30 a.m. in the morning on Fridays at the Marriott Hotel. What time? We're going to launch it.
Yes, we're going to launch it.
And this will change your life. This is a book by Bishop Dr. Robert Gordon Kisseh. It's out there. Then you get it and find it. Ref, your final thoughts. That's your camera right there. I'm sure the businessmen are watching. They want
yes.
to take away something.
Okay. Now, my aim for sharing with you is because there's a lot of people who mean very well. They are putting a lot of effort, and yet they are achieving very little. It's never too late to do the right thing. There are things that you think you want to do. You've not been able to do it. This book is to help you open up yourself because God gave us dominion when He created us. He gave man dominion. And that dominion is to help you occupy and be in charge. And therefore, as you begin to believe that God is going to use you to bring business success, that success will bring many, many, many people to come to know that business can succeed, no matter the environment. Mm. Because many people blame success of business on the environment.
Right.
I think that the environment can be a challenge that cannot prevent business success.
Bishop, thank you very much. Always coming up with practical and wise words that you must apply in your life. And that's the founding overseer of the Life Churches. He's also an education, he's a pioneer of Christian education in Ghana. And he is also a pastor's pastor, Bishop Dr. Gordon Kisseh.